It's your favorite YouTube dealer. I appreciate you guys for stopping in. I just rolled out of bed a little while ago, and I thought the only thing that I had to check out this morning was Nicki Minaj's Bigfoot responding to Megan Thee Stallion. And then on Twitter, I came across somebody saying that Benzino responded to Eminem with a diss called Vulturious. So I figured we would dive in. I'm not really a Benzino fan. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you, but I'm a big Coi Leray fan. His daughter is fire. And I don't mean musically. I mean, hold up. I should cut this out. No, she makes some decent music. I'm not saying she doesn't, but I'm just saying I am extremely attracted to that woman. And so because of that, I'm going to give her father a chance. We're going to see what this man is cooking with. So let's dive in. Let's find out.
Yo, Eminem should be called Skittles, sweet ass motherfucker.
Candy ass Eminem, bitch ass feminine, Maddie like melanin, on value turned up again. Oh shit, here we go, Benzino versus Jim Crow. Noah Custy when I see one, how many times you overdose? Cracker on crack.
Okay, so first off, he's kind of going with the most played stuff. Eminem, feminine. It's like, all right, you mad because you lack melanin. It's really kind of not that great. And then he brings up the fact that he's a custy. I can see it. You almost overdosed, which we all know. This is like public knowledge of Eminem. It's not like it's a secret that he overdosed almost one time and that he used to do drugs. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get it. Like, you can utilize these facts about Eminem and twist it into some kind of a story or like create a better narrative around it instead of just blatantly saying it, because just saying something that's already known by everybody is not really, it's not really that big of a diss anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like, you've got to try to build something around it to make it make sense. I think personals are definitely the best thing that you could do in a diss track, but I just feel like it's got to be done in a certain way, especially when it's knowledge that everybody has. Because it's different if you were pointing this out and nobody knew and everyone was like, wait, I'm almost overdosed. Wait, he was a drug addict at one point? Like, then it would be like a really big thing. But the fact that it's known by everybody, you've got to create a way to make it interesting. That makes sense. And the way that this started with the gunshots, what is that from? Is that from like 50 Cent dissing somebody, or there's some kind of a diss track that starts with the gunshots in the beginning? I, if I'm not mistaken, I could be wrong.
Yo, Eminem should be called Skittles, sweet ass motherfucker.
Candy ass Eminem, bitch ass feminine, Maddie like melanin, on value turned up again. Oh shit, here we go, Benzino versus Jim Crow. Noah Custy when I see one, how many times you overdose? Cracker on crack, who rap, I hate black in the show. Invade our culture, then insult us, time you get exposed.
See, this is, I didn't mean to do this to just disrespect Benzino, but he's just saying a lot of shit that's not true. Like, saying that he hates black people, that's clearly not the case. And then he says that he gets into black culture and disrespects it. When has Eminem ever been disrespectful to anybody in black culture or to black culture itself? He constantly is showing love to everybody, the people that came before him, to just music in general. Like, these are, like, I get where he's trying to come from in the sense that he's trying to create a diss track. I get that. But you can't just make shit up completely. Now, if you built a narrative around it and it made it seem like it was true, then people might question it. But again, he's just saying facts that aren't real or facts that we already know, as far as like the drug addict thing, not the, you know, black culture thing. So it's like, I don't get what his approach is.
This Mariah, Christina, Michael, and Britney. What kind of fuck go to war with people dancing and singing? Don't fuck with 50 and keep it a buck. You ain't tough. Your baby mom can get a bag like how Cassie did Puff. If they read your lyrics in the court like they did Young Thug. From the drugs, chopping her up. Corpse in the trunk. You a punk. Plan my funeral, please. You shoot who? You who? Square ain't even go circle the block for proof. And the truth, my daughter had a life that...
That was a diss. See, that's a diss right there. That's actually crazy that he just said that. That's wild. That's okay. See, that's, I mean, listen, I'm not saying that he should have said something like that. It's a little disrespectful, but that's the whole point of a diss track. Disrespectful. That's the point of it. So that was a bar. He's like, something about you ain't even go spin the block for proof. That's what he should have been doing this entire track. Up until now, he's just kind of just chatting. You know what I'm saying? It's not much coming. So that's what you do. Right there is what you do.
Like how Cassie did Puff.
Although the one bar that he said about like your ex can do to you what Cassie did to Puff. Like, that could bring about some questions in people's head. Like, I said, I'm an Eminem fan, but I'm going to try to look at this as unbiased as possible and give him a little bit of credit here and there where I feel like it's due. The Proof bar, that was fire. That's what a diss track needs to be, and not just one bar. The entirety of it has to be scathing like that. It's got to be some shit. You know what I'm saying? And then the part about his ex, that one, I feel like there's a little bit of something to it. I get what he's saying. Like, if they would use your lyrics in court like they're doing to Young Thug, where you're talking about basically tying her up, beating her, doing all these different things, like, then you should be getting in trouble too. Like, I get where he's coming from with that. So this part of the diss is actually functional. It's actually the way that it should be.
They beat your lyrics in the court like they did Young Thug. From the drugs, chopping her up, corpse in the trunk. You a punk. Plan my funeral, please. You shoot who? You who? Square ain't even go circle the block for proof. And the truth, my daughter had a life that I never had. I'm probably more Boston George than America's dad. But I provided food, clothes, gifts, kept y'all excited. Now you let the industry Willie Lynch keep us divided. But
this part didn't have to be in here. If you wanted to just come out and make a statement about how your daughter had a life that you never had and how you did your best and so on and so forth, you could just talk about that. Don't put that in a diss track. The one thing I don't like in diss tracks is when people talk about themselves. Unless you talking about yourself somehow is inherently dissing the person that you're dissing, you're just wasting bars. I feel like every bar should be going towards dissing and disrespecting, making fun of whatever it is about the person that you're talking to. When you start to include yourself into it, now it's just you're making it more of a song.
But back when I got indicted in and out of court fighting, you was in a pretty home with something foreign to ride in. Of course I'll tell you hate your father, he could never find his trailer park swine bitch. Shit, you're miserable when you're lonely, and we think that they clone you. You look weird, don't care how much just for men they put on you. Never seen with a girl, never seen with a bitch. Forgot a song, what if I was gay with joy the Lucas. I'm done.
I forget if I did a reaction to that. I meant to do a reaction to the song with him and Joyner called I'm Gay. I mean, I don't think that there's anything wrong with them having fun with some stuff. But again, that is something that you can utilize in a diss to try to throw some shots. I feel like, again, build up around it. Don't just say you did this, right? Like, sometimes you got to take what they did and then create a narrative about it, because that's how it becomes like a real good diss. If that makes sense. Now, there was a part back here that I wanted to talk about real quick.
Those gifts kept y'all excited. Now you let the industry Willie Lynch keep us divided. But back when I got indicted in and out of court fighting, you was in a pretty home with something foreign to ride in. Of course, I'll tell you hate your father. He could never find his.
Now, I don't know if he's talking about his daughter or Eminem, because it seems like he was talking about his daughter, and then he said something about when I was in and out of court getting indicted, you was in a nice home with something foreign to ride in. I assume he's talking about his daughter, trying to say like I was taking care of her regardless. If he's talking about Eminem, I don't feel like that's a great diss. It's just you're basically saying that he was successful. So I feel like he's talking about his daughter, which that's where it gets a little bit odd. It's a diss track. This isn't a track where you're trying to explain to your daughter the way things were.
In and out of court.
Well, let me go back a little bit further to get more context on it.
Now you let the industry Willie Lynch keep us divided.
See, because he's talking about his daughter. You're letting the industry keep us divided, you know, so on and so forth. And then he says the whole, when I was in and out of court getting indicted, you was in a pretty home with something foreign to ride in. So I'm pretty sure this is all just bars to kind of explain something to his daughter.
Gifts kept y'all excited. Now you let the industry Willie Lynch keep us divided. But back when I got indicted in and out of court fighting, you was in a pretty home with something foreign to ride in.
I realized that he said the industry Willie Lynch. Is that what he's calling M?
Of course I'll tell you hate your father. He could never find his.
Now that was a pretty cool bar. It did build up to that. Like, of course I'll tell you hate your father. He could never find his. That was a good bar. Like I said, I'm going to give him his props where you know, props are deserved.
Trailer park swine, bitch. Shit. You're miserable when you're lonely. And we think that they clone you. You look weird, don't care how much just for men they put on you. Never seen with a girl, never seen with a bitch. Forgot a song, what if I was gay, would join the Lucas.
That wasn't the worst, because he did say you never seen with a girl, you never seen with a bitch, and then you got this song with Joyner Lucas. So it was decent. There wasn't anything crazy. I think the whole the of course he'll tell you to hate your father, he can never find his, I think that was a legit bar. I think the square never circled the block for proof or spun the block for proof, that was probably the highlight of this diss track. And that was some raw shit to say. So again, that's the whole point of a diss track. That's what you're supposed to do. But overall, on a whole, this wasn't all that great. It wasn't the greatest. I mean, I didn't have that high of expectations. Obviously, Benzino is not going to hang with Eminem when it comes to disses. But I was going to say, you know, we'll see if Eminem responds, but I don't know that he will. Maybe because of the proof bar, that could get him a little bit upset, but I just don't feel like he's going to give more attention to Benzino. I feel like what he did was just kind of like, I'm just having some fun with it. I'm going to throw some shots just out of, you know, just for a laugh type of shit. And, you know, Benzino's like, this is an opportunity for me to get some attention myself. And I don't think M's going to give him any more. But like I said, I'll give him his props for those couple of bars. But overall, not really the greatest diss track. You've got to create that narrative. You got to do that proof bar 12 times over throughout the entirety of the track. And then you got some crazy shit that people got to respond to. That's just my opinion. Let me know what you guys thought down below. I appreciate you for stopping in. And I will catch you in the next, I was going to say episode. I'm thinking of my anime reactions. Which links down below if anybody likes anime and wants to watch with me. We got a lot of stuff going on over there, but I will catch you in the next video, homies.